Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about one-way ANOVA. Why it is called one-way ANOVA? Because it is classified only according to one factor or one criterion. This video is sponsored by Pharma Tutor. They provide job alerts, pharma newsletters, admission alerts, articles and many more. You can also join online test series for GPAT preparation. Download dedicated Pharma Tutor app for regular notifications. Visit www.pharmatutor.org for more details. Link is given in the description. Now coming to the steps involved in one-way ANOVA. So to explain that steps, first we will take an example which will be like this. So here we are having three samples. First one is A. In A we are having three readings, that is 2, 4, 6. Second one is B. In B we are having 3, 5, and 7. And the third one is C. In C we are having 4, 6, and 8. Total of this 2 plus 4 plus 6 is equal to 12. For B, 3 plus 5 plus 7 will be equal to 15. For C, 4 plus 6 plus 8 will be 18. Now coming to the null hypothesis for this data. So null hypothesis is equal to XA bar is equal to XB bar is equal to XC bar. These are the mean of this A, B and C data. Now coming to the alternative hypothesis. So alternative hypothesis will be XA bar is not equal to XB bar is again not equal to XC bar. So first step to perform one-way ANOVA will be to state the null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis. Now coming to the second step of one-way ANOVA, that is calculate the variance between the samples. So to calculate the variance between the sample, first step or step A will be the calculation of mean for these samples. So for calculation of mean of each sample, first one is XA bar is equal to 12 divided by 3, 12 divided by n, and here n is equal to 3, so it will be 4. Now coming to the second one, that is XB bar. So XB bar is equal to 15 divided by 3, so it will be 5. Now coming to the third one, which is XC bar. So XC bar is equal to 18 divided by 3, so it will be 6. So in this step we have calculated the mean of each sample, which is 4, 5 and 6 respectively. Now coming to the next step, which is B. So that is calculation of a grand average for these means. So grand average is denoted by X double bar, and X double bar is equal to XA bar plus XB bar plus XC bar. And here we have taken 1, 2 and 3 means. So it will be divided by 3. Now we will put all these values. So it will be XA bar is equal to 4 plus XB bar is equal to 5 plus XC bar is equal to 6. So 4 plus 5 plus 6 divided by 3. So ultimately it will be 15 divided by 3. So grand average will be equal to 5. It means X bar is equal to 5. It is value of X bar. Now coming to step C. So in this C step, we will take the difference between the means of various samples and grand average, that is x double bar and square it. So representation will be like this. So first column is for x a bar minus x double bar. Second column is for x a bar minus x double bar square. Third column is for x b bar minus x double bar. Fourth column is for x b bar minus x double bar square. Fifth column is for x c bar minus x double bar, and the last column is for x c bar minus x double bar square. Now we will put the values in this column. So it will be x a bar, and x a bar is equal to 4, and 4 minus x double bar is equal to 5. So it will be minus 1. And here in second and third also it will be same, 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1, 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1, and minus 1 square will be 1, and here also it will be 1, and here also it will be 1. Now coming to the x b bar minus x double bar. So value of x b bar is equal to 5. So 5 minus x double bar is equal to again 5. So ultimately it will be 0. In second also it will be 5 minus 5 is equal to 0, and in third also 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. So ultimately 0 square will be 0. Now coming to the third one, that is x c bar. So x c bar is equal to 6, and 6 minus x double bar 5, so it will be 1. Again it will be 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. Again it is 6 minus 5 is equal to 1. So 1 square will be 1, 1 square will be again 1, and 1 square will be again 1. Now coming to the value of summation x bar minus x double bar. So it will be 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3, 0 plus 0 plus 0 is equal to 0, and 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to again 3. So sum of square between the samples is equal to 3 plus 0 plus 3, and it will be equal to 6. So in one way ANOVA, first step is to state the null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Second step is calculate the variance between the sample, and the third step will be calculate the variance within the sample. So in this step also calculation will be same like this, that is calculation of mean for each sample. So mean for each sample will be same. For x a bar it will be 4, for x b bar it will be 5, and for x c bar it will be 6. Now coming to the step b. So in step B, take the deviations of the various items in a sample from the mean values of the respective sample and square it. So table for this calculation will be like this. So in first column we will take A minus X A bar. In second column we will take A minus X A bar square. In third column we will take B minus X B bar. In fourth column we will take B minus X B bar square. In fifth column we will take C minus X C bar, and in last column we will take C minus X C bar square. So coming to the first one, where A is equal to 2, So 2 minus x a bar is equal to 4. 2 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. Second one is 4. So 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. Third one is 6. So 6 minus 4 is equal to plus 2. And minus 2 square will be 4. 0 square will be 0. 2 square will be 4. Now coming to the third column. So here it is 3. So 3 minus x b bar, which is 5. So 3 minus 5 is equal to minus 2. Second one is 5. So 5 minus 5 is equal to 0. Third one is 7. So 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. And minus 2 square will be 4. 0 square will be 0. And plus 2 square will be again 4. Now coming to the next one. So here it is 4. So 4 minus x c bar, which is 6. So 4 minus 6 is equal to 2. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Here it is 6. Then 8. So 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. Minus, it will be minus 2. So minus 2 square will be 4. 0 square will be 0. 2 square will be 4. Now coming to the value of summation x minus x bar square. Here also it will be summation x bar minus x double bar square. So here it will be 4 plus 0 plus 4 is equal to 8. Here it will be 4 plus 0 plus 4 is equal to again 8. And here also it will be 4 plus 0 plus 4 is equal to again 8. So here value for sum of square within the sample will be 8 plus 8 plus 8, because here it is 8, here also it is 8, here also it is 8. So total will be 24. Now in next step we have to calculate the ratio of f by using the table like this. So first column is for source of variation. And it is categorized into two parts, that is between the sample and within the sample. Now coming to the second column, which is for sum of squares. And it is categorized into two parts, that is SSC and the second one is SSE. Next column is for degree of freedom. Degree of freedom is again categorized into two parts. First one is nu1, and nu1 is equal to number of columns minus 1, and nu2 is equal to n, which is total number of observations minus number of columns, that is c. Now coming to the next column, which is mean sum of squares. So it is again categorized into two part, which is MSC, and MSC is equal to SSC divided by C minus 1, and the second one is MSE, and MSE is equal to SSE divided by N minus C, and MSC is equal to mean sum of squares between the sample. And MSE is equal to mean sum of squares within the sample. Now coming to the next column, which is for F ratio. And F ratio is equal to MSC divided by MSE. Now we will put all these values required in this table. So SSC is equal to 6 is equal to 6, SSE is equal to 24. So new 1 is equal to C minus 1. So here you can see that 1, 2 and 3 columns are present. So it will be 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Here न्यू टू और डिग्री ऑफ फ्रीडम फॉर सेकंड वन इज एन माइनस सी. सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट थ्री कॉलम्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड थ्री रोस आर प्रेजेंट. सो थ्री इंटू थ्री इज इक्वल टू नाइन. दैट इज एन. नाइन माइनस नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स दैट इज थ्री. सो नाइन माइनस थ्री इज इक्वल टू सिक्स. सो न्यू टू विल बी इक्वल टू सिक्स. नाउ कमिंग टू द एम एस सी. सो एम एस सी इज इक्वल टू एस एस सी बाई सी माइनस वन. सो एस एस सी इज इक्वल टू सिक्स डिवाइडेड बाई टू. सो सिक्स बाई टू इज इक्वल टू थ्री. नाउ कमिंग टू द एम एस सी. सो एम एस सी इज इक्वल टू एस एस ई विच इज 24 डिवाइडेड बाई 6. सो इट विल बी इक्वल टू 24 बाई 6 इज इक्वल टू 4. नाउ कमिंग टू द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एफ. सो एफ इज इक्वल टू एम एस सी दैट इज 3 डिवाइडेड बाई एम एस ई दैट इज 4. सो अल्टीमेटली एफ इज इक्वल टू कैलकुलेटेड एफ वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू 3 बाई 4 विच इज 0.75. So this is step C. Now coming to the step D. So in step D we will compare this calculated F value with tabulated F value. So first we have to see the tabulated value for new 1 is equal to 2 and new 2 is equal to 6. So it is 5.14 as it is visible in your screen. Now last step will be decision making. So here you can see that tabulated value is 5.14 and the calculated value is 0.75. It means there is no significant difference between this x a bar, x b bar and x c bar. So our null hypothesis is passed. It means we have to reject our alternative hypothesis. So our decision will be null hypothesis is correct in this case. So this is the complete details and steps about one-way ANOVA. Now in my next video, I will discuss about few questions related to one-way ANOVA. Thank you.